fieldwork is the hallmark of USI's geology program, and Professor Paul Doss's students don't have to stray far from the classroom to uncover hidden gems. This ancient stream bed leads to a seasonal waterfall, one of several right here on USI's campus. Today, students are examining clues revealed by the exposed rock face.
You know, it's really cool that we have these spots on campus and have these rocks exposed here. We can use those cross beds to indicate current direction. So at the time these rocks were formed, if you have a good understanding of the orientation of those features, you can identify specific direction that water was flowing 300 million years ago in the surface water that was making these rocks. And that's so cool.
So you want to pay particular attention to the weathering processes that are out there. We talked about mechanical and chemical weathering processes. We looked at sedimentary rocks in the labs. We want to try to identify sedimentary rocks, describe them. You're going to want to be looking at all of those different criteria when we're out there. And the only way you can do that is to actually go up and touch the rocks.
Back in the classroom, Professor Jim Durbin's students are reviewing rock formations before heading to the natural amphitheater. The natural beauty of USI's campus is revealed in this field lab that gives students an opportunity to learn by looking, touching, and testing the sedimentation.
What other hard mineral would you expect to find commonly in sandstone?
Heavy feldspar?
Feldspars, right?
Yeah.
So where are the feldspars?
Washed out.
Washed out. Be more specific.
Weathered.
Right? So they're weathered away.
Meanwhile, Professor Paul Doss and undergraduate student Chance Ford have followed their creek bed to Reflection Lake on campus. They are preparing for a journey to the North Woods of Michigan, where Chance will spend the summer doing groundwater research with the United States Forest Service. Today, Chance is placing a seepage meter below the lake's surface to measure groundwater flow into the lake.
Try to get it installed where there hasn't been any disturbance if you can.
Okay.
And then you remember, as you get it into the sediment interface, try to just go vertically, straight down. If you need to rotate it, that's okay. But try not to cock it. You don't want to make any sort of a preferred pathway along the margins of that meter.
I feel like this kind of opportunity to be able to do research, faculty-led research, especially at an undergraduate level, I mean, it's cool. I don't know if I'd get this at any other school. This idea of being able to do hands-on research, especially right here on campus. I mean, I can come down here on a Saturday afternoon and put the seepage meter in that I've built with, you know, help from Dr. Doss and some others. The idea that I'll be able to then possibly present my research and findings from right here on campus to professional geologists, professionals in my field, it's pretty cool. It's amazing.
The Pott College of Science, Engineering, and Education is one of four colleges that make up the University of Southern Indiana. This growing campus set in Evansville, Indiana, features a beautiful natural landscape complemented by well-appointed and technology-rich classroom buildings. We've just expanded the Greenbelt Trail system that wanders through campus, updated our fitness center, and we're preparing a state-of-the-art teaching theater. Our recently renovated university center is a popular gathering place for students throughout the year. Evansville is Indiana's third largest city and boasts an attractive, vibrant, and thriving downtown along the banks of the Ohio River. Home to a new arena, as well as historic landmarks, there's always something to do. USI offers students a great mix of urban access and rural charm. It's a place that students are proud to call their university.
I think it's a very student-centered environment. I think a lot of different kinds of students can be successful here.
I feel like I've actually developed a sense of dedication and responsibility to not just my life and my goals, but also to the field of science as well.
No matter who you are, what you like, what you dislike, you'll be able to fit in. You'll be able to find your little niche, you know, of where you belong here. And so you're not going to be an outcast. You're not going to be an outsider. There's always room for you.
We think you will like being at USI and the Pott College of Science, Engineering, and Education as well. our graduates are well prepared for life and go on to do wonderful things. More than 85% of the Pott College graduates who apply are accepted into medical, professional, or graduate schools, and the remaining enter directly into the workforce and begin high-paying, productive careers. We'd love to add you to this list of outstanding graduates. Please visit us on the web at www.usi.edu.